Living in Mendoza as an expat is one of the best decisions we have ever made as a couple. And I'm about to share you why it could be the perfect one for you too. Hey everyone, in this video, I will be sharing my thoughts on the pros and cons of living in Mendoza based on my own experience as a foreigner who has lived here for the past 2 years. If you're a newcomer or considering making Mendoza your new home, this video is for you. Let's start with the advantages. Living in Mendoza means you have easy access to outdoor adventures, from trekking to skiing in the winter. The landscapes of the Andes Mountains are right at your doorstep. You can visit Aconcagua, the highest peak in the Americas, which has incredible hiking, camping spots, and horseback riding. In the winter, you can go to Las Leñas, a ski resort which is around 4 hours away from the city by bus, or drive 2 hours to Los Penitentes from the city center. There are slopes suitable for beginners to advanced skiers. During the warm season, you can visit the natural thermal hot spring like Cachauta, which is about 40 minutes bus ride from the city. There is Cerro Arco, 20 minutes from the city center, where you can go paragliding at the mountains. There are endless of outdoor activities to do, as well as in other provinces in Mendoza. Argentina's economy is pretty unpredictable. Inflation rates can go up and down a lot, which really affects the prices of goods and services. Compared to other cities in this country, Mendoza offers a low cost of living. Houses, whether renting or buying, is more affordable. Rental and property purchase prices are lower, making it easier for residents to find cost-effective living arrangements. Everyday expenses like groceries, utility bills, and general living costs remain relatively affordable, allowing expats to maintain a comfortable lifestyle without needing a large budget. However, dining out has become noticeably more expensive than usual recently. If you want to know more about the cost of living in Mendoza, you can watch a detailed video about it here. Traffic in Mendoza province and the city isn't that bad at all. You'll find traffic lights all over and pedestrian lights in some spots. The average traffic time is generally manageable, even during rush hours when it gets the busiest. When I first got here, a lot of people warned me about the horrible traffic. But when I was living in the Philippines, especially in Manila, which has a massive 12 million people, I used to spend 2 hours commuting from home to office, a trip that should have only taken 20 minutes, more or less, without the traffic. If you didn't know, Mendoza enjoys a sunny climate with over 300 days of sunshine per year. After living here, I can say that I have witnessed around 10 heavy rainfalls per year. Summers can be hot and dry, with temperatures often exceeding 33 degrees Celsius, but winters are mild and pleasant. You can spend your weekends at Parque General San Martin, a stunning park that's perfect for everyone to enjoy picnics, engaging in outdoor activities such as kayaking and potrerios, or you can simply enjoy the basking sunshine. The pace of life in Mendoza is more relaxed. For example, you might enjoy the local siesta culture, like provinces in Spain, where many businesses close in the early afternoon for a long lunch and rest. Most businesses also close on Sundays. This allows everyone to slow down and enjoy life a more relaxed pace. There's no rush to get things done. So if you're someone who thrives in a fast-paced environment, this might be a downside for you. Mendoza is famous worldwide for its wine, especially Malbec. This reputation draws visitors from all over who come for wine tourism. For instance, there are lots of well-known wineries making award-winning wines and offering tours and tastings. As an expat, you could spend weekends exploring different wineries, enjoying tastings paired with gourmet food. You might also find jobs in tourism such as guiding wine tours or working in hotels, especially if you speak 2 or more languages. However, the pay might not be as high as you hope. Mendoza is such a hidden gem. Especially if you're into exploring on foot, this city practically invites you to get out and move. It's super walkable and bike friendly thanks to its smart urban design. You'll find bikes stationed around different spots, which you can rent using the Bisitan app. Now imagine this, wide tree-lined avenues crisscrossing the city with spacious sidewalks that are perfect for a casual stroll. One of the coolest things about Mendoza is how it's centered around these beautiful plazas. The main hub is, of course, Plaza Independencia. And from there, you can easily wander to other plazas. They're not just a scenic spots, they're the heartbeat of the city. People gather here to chat, relax, and soak up to the vibe. I've made detailed video about it, and I'll link it over here, which you can watch later. Mendocinians are known for their warmth and hospitality, making it easier for foreigners to make friends and feel part of the community. There are always social gatherings and family events happening, giving you plenty of chances to connect with locals. As someone who's half Asian and spent most of my life in Asia, I was honestly surprised by how welcoming Mendoza is. I'm used to a more reserved, distant social vibe, so the kindness here was a really pleasant shift. From the moment I arrived, everyone from neighbors to complete strangers greeted us with open arms. It took some time getting used to, especially coming from a place where people tend to keep more to themselves. Did you know that Mendoza is known as one of the safest cities in Argentina? Sure, crime can happen anywhere, but Mendoza has a pretty low crime rate. When I first stepped foot here, I noticed that the police are really active by doing routine checks, and the well-lit streets make it feel safe even at night. The community is super committed to safety, with lots of people taking part in neighborhood watch programs. The residents take pride in their city and work together to keep it safe and welcoming for everyone. Next are the disadvantages. While some locals, particularly those in the tourism industry, speak English, Spanish is the primary language in Mendoza. Daily interactions such as shopping, dealing with government services, and socializing overall generally requires a good command of Spanish. Language classes and immersion with friends can be beneficial. For instance, if you need to visit a local clinic, you might struggle to communicate with your medical needs if you don't speak Spanish, and it's rare sight to find a doctor that speaks English. Therefore, learning the language is essential for effectively navigating daily life. Living in Mendoza has its challenges when it comes to food. Dining out, the options are mostly pizza, pastas, hot dogs, burgers, milanesas, and empanadas, with almost every cafe serving similar dishes. So as a couple, we mostly cook at home. Currently, Mendoza now has Bolivian, Peruvian, Indian, Venezuelan, and Thai restaurants, and a few Japanese places too. If you want authentic or other international dishes, you might have to travel to Chile or Buenos Aires. Finding a job in Mendoza can be challenging, especially if you don't speak Spanish, and working here might not be the best recommendation. Job opportunities are often limited, and salaries might not match what you're accustomed to. Many expats find work in tourism, teaching English, or doing remote jobs for international companies. Local businesses face significant struggles due to high inflation and taxes. If you're thinking about starting your own business, you might want to explore some innovative ideas like offering international dance classes, providing postnatal services, or introducing a variety of cuisine options. There's also a gap for home food deliveries such as vegan, halal, or meal prep for workouts, which aren't that common in the area yet. However, starting a business in Argentina right now is generally not advisable. Investment security is lacking, bureaucracy is overwhelming, and the taxes are excessively high. Especially for someone who doesn't speak the language, lacks family connections, and doesn't understand the cultural specifics, opening a business here is not recommended at this time. Mendoza is quite a distance from Argentina's major cities like Buenos Aires, Mar del Plata, and Córdoba. So traveling there takes more time and money, If your embassy or consulate is in the capital, you'll find yourself making frequent trips, which can become quite a hassle. Buying anything from abroad is still impossible or is triple the cost. So shopping trips and meals are still very much a thing. Plus, since Mendoza is smaller, it doesn't have as many amenities and services as bigger cities. For example, finding specialized medical care or certain international products can be tough. While there is an expat community in Mendoza, it's smaller than in the bigger cities, making it harder to find specific support, networks, and social groups for foreigners. This can sometimes make you feel a bit lonely or disconnected, especially if you're used to a busier city life. Also, international conferences or events and other activities might not happen as often here. If you enjoy a vibrant social scene, you might need to adjust to your expectations or travel to a larger city for certain experiences. Newer technologies and gadgets are expensive and are hard to find in Mendoza, which can be quite inconvenient. Tech expos are also non-existent. If you need to buy, repair, or check your tech devices, you might have to travel to Buenos Aires or even Chile. For instance, last year I needed to replace my laptop's battery, but because my laptop was a newer model, no stores in Mendoza and the online stores in Buenos Aires had it in stock. This meant I had to wait a long time for it to be ordered or travel to another country to get it replaced. Additionally, finding specific tech accessories or latest gadget can be challenging, leading to delays. So if you rely on technology for work or personal use, it's important to plan ahead and be prepared for these challenges. So to sum it up, living in Mendoza has its perks and challenges. I would honestly spend my retirement years here as it's a place with a lot of charm and warmth. But it's important to weigh these factors if you're thinking about making it your new home.